Hey! As you can tell by the title, today I'll be coding my own auto-job bot for Scribble.io. Oh, what's the reason for this, you ask? Yeah, no clue. Anyways, ignoring my clear lack of drawing skills, let's get this thing started. The idea behind the program is simple. We have an item that we want to draw. Make the program recognize which image we want to draw and load it. Get a pixel from the picture and look at its color. Find out which color from our palette is the closest. Select the color from the palette and move the mouse onto the board and also draw a dot in that position. Then we just repeat that for all the pixels on the image, and that would be it, really. Really simple stuff. So let's get to the coding part. First, loading the image. Fairly simple. All I do is say what the name of the file is and make the picture box hold that image. Next thing I did was get the dimensions of the board, so I knew what to resize the image to. Since I don't know how to do this, I just googled it and oh, would you look at that? Yoink. Now I just plunk it somewhere over here. And oh, perfect. Now that the image automatically resizes to the board size, I had to actually find the correct position on the screen, which turned out to be a bit more tricky when you have two monitors, but I still managed somehow. When I finally found the position, I started making it so that it would go through the entire board, placing the mouse at every pixel's position. Just like that. And now, since the drawing area and the selected image are the same size, it means we can just loop through them without any size problems occurring. Next, I wanted to get the colors from the image. To test that, I made a debug label and made it display the RGB value of the selected pixel while looping through the image. But, as it turns out, going through the entire image, pixel by pixel, while setting the mouse to the corresponding position on the monitor, while getting the pixel color from the pixel, and setting the debug label to that color value, while refreshing the entire window so that I could see the changes, is actually really damn slow. It was so slow, I don't actually think it would have finished drawing in one round. So I just ended not using the debug label in the end. Also, watching this made me realize I should have probably added a failsafe if anything went wrong like before, but hey, where would be the fun in that? Anyways, now that I was getting the colors from the image, it was time to compare them with the colors on the Scribble palette and find the closest one. Again, since I didn't know how to do this, I just googled it and yeah. Now, that function only tells me if two colors are close. I still had to figure out which one was the closest. To find that out, I declared all the colors from the palette and sent them through one by one through that function. And whichever returned a positive first was chosen. I'm not gonna lie, I'm not really proud of this code, but it's gonna do for now. Now, with the closest color returned, I just matched the color and moved the mouse to the color's corresponding location on the palette and made it left click to select it. Now, I had the program working, but there was one tiny problem. It's so goddamn slow! Like, look at this! The round ended before it could even do a quarter of the drawing. Okay, so it's clear that the program needs some small optimizations. The first optimization I added was that it would store what the last color was and compare it with the new selected color. And if they were the same, logically it didn't have to move the mouse onto the palette and select the color again. That made it fast enough to run in one round, but still not as fast as I wanted it to be. So the next thing I changed was that the program didn't go through all the pixels, because thinking logically about this, let's say the brush is 5 pixels big. Theoretically speaking, instead of going through all the pixels, we can just check each fifth one, basically reducing the pixel count to 1/5 of what it was before. With this, we lose quality, but gain a big performance boost in return. Now, with the optimizations in place, I went and called some friends to test it out.
Almost.
What the f*** am I missing?
Peppa's pig.
I don't know.
Peppa's pig.
Dude. It's launching.
But
what? Wait. I'm doing it. Okay.
This is kind of sus,
okay. Man. Yeah. There we go.
Oh.
This is why you wanted to play, huh?
Now, I will admit, the program isn't perfect. It gets the colors wrong, it's really slow, and on top of that, before you find a decent picture of what you wanted to draw, everyone already becomes suspicious. Overall, it was still a fun little challenge, and I hope you enjoyed watching. I'll leave you with some more clips of the program in action. Thank you.